the DNA of each animal is specific and unique. At the Laboratory for Conservation of Endangered Species, they are also doing a lot of forensic work. Like this is a case of an ivory. We do not know whether this is Asian ivory or this is African elephant ivory, but the DNA can tell us. Let's look at some other cases. Here is a case of an rhino horn. This is a horn from an African rhino seized in India, but came for laboratory analysis and identification at this unique laboratory, and they were able to tell that this is a rhino horn and this is a horn of an African rhino. In the same fashion, here is a seized skin of a leopard. This leopard was killed somewhere and then it came to this laboratory for identification whether it is a male leopard or a female leopard. All of this helps in final nailing down of the criminal. But sometimes criminals cheat themselves. Cheating the cheats. I will show you a very interesting case. Here is a case of what looks like really tiger skin. This is not a tiger skin. This is a dog skin which has been painted to look like a tiger. Here at this laboratory, they were able to do DNA identification and figure out that this was not a tiger skin, but here cheats were cheating cheats and trying to make money off people. So this is a case of a forgery. The person who did this also probably went to jail, not for poaching, not under wildlife protection, but for forgery. So DNA being used at the hilt for helping mankind, not just resurrect animals, but also helping in the protection and reducing the wildlife crime. With camera person Nagraj in Hyderabad, Pallav Bagla for NDTV.